Class 4 students, I hope you all are good and safe at your places. So, welcome back to our EVS class. As you all know, we were doing chapter number 19, paying for travel, and your vivas are going on. I hope you all are doing very good. So, yes, today we will be completing this chapter in this session. And our bookwork is completed only, notebook work is pending. So, today we will be completing that. First of all, we will be doing keywords, then very short question answers, and then long question answers. So everyone, open your EVS notebook and start writing with me. So everyone, write down the date. Your date is 17th of December. And then you will be writing your classwork and make a heading of chapter number 19, paying for travel. Okay, and then make a heading of keywords like this. Total 8 keywords are here. We are starting with the first keyword. So the keyword number first is impressed. So what is the meaning of impressed? Impressed means to make somebody feel respect. मतलब कोई अपने आप को किसी चीज में हमें feel कर रहे हम feel कर रहे हैं respect feel कर रहे हैं that is the meaning of impressed. To impress someone, like to make somebody feel respect. After that, spelling is impressed, impressed. Then second is reserved. So what is the meaning of reserved? Reserved means ask for a seat or a room, or we can say any place if we want to book that seat or book that place. So that is reserved. Ki humne pehle hi us cheez ko book karwa li hai. Reserved, or we can say reservation. Okay, then third is convenient. Convenient meaning not causing difficulty, like easily. Which is very easy thing for us, which is convenient for us, we can say. So, जो चीज़ हमें बहुत easily मिल जाती है, we can say, जो हमें easily लग रही है, that is convenient for us. Okay, and then entire means whole or all, मतलब सभी जगह की बात करें, complete thing की बात करें, that is the meaning of entire. And then triumph. Triumph means a great success. A great success, that is the triumph meaning. T-R-I-U-M-P-H, triumph. Then violence. Violence is the like to doing some such things to damage somebody physically. Right? That is the meaning of violence. To kisi ko maarna, kisi ko physically harm karna. This is the violence, and non-violence is the thing, it is just opposite of violence. It is the behavior for the fighting for political change, or hum freedom ke liye fight kar rahe hain. Jaise Gandhi ji ne freedom ke liye fight kiya tha, and he just followed this rule, non-violence. And it means fight but without using any force. Koi force use nahi kar rahe, we are not harming anybody. So this is just opposite to the violence, that is non-violence. Next is cheap. Cheap. So cheap means low in price. Price just is kam hota, that is known as cheap. So these are the 8 keywords. Again I am repeating. Impressed, reserved, convenient, entire, triumph, violence, non-violence, and cheap. Giving you few seconds to write it, then we will be doing very short questions. So yes students, now everyone make a heading of very short question answer. So here we are starting with the first very short question answer is, what is the meaning of Satyamev Jayate? So yes, Satyamev Jayate is the like motto, the meaning of the Satyamev Jayate, we have to explain in this question. So everyone write question number first. What is the meaning of Satyamev Jayate? And answer is, the meaning of Satyamev Jayate is truth alone triumphs. Truth alone triumphs means that हमेशा जो सत्य ही जीतता है, सत्य अकेला जीतता है. ओके, सो द मीनिंग ऑफ सत्यमेव जयते इज ट्रुथ अलोन ट्रायम्फ्स. सो एवरीवन नोट इट डाउन इन योर नोटबुक्स. What is the meaning of Satyamev Jayate? The meaning of Satyamev Jayate is truth alone triumphs. Okay, now the question number 2. Name the two pictures we have on our bank notes. Jo hamare bank ke notes pe two pictures hain, we have to tell their names. Name the two pictures we have on our bank notes. Now the answer is, the two pictures we have on our bank notes are of Mahatma Gandhi, M-A-H-A-T-M-A, Mahatma Gandhi, G-A-N-D-H-I Gandhi, and one picture is of our national emblem. National and A-T-I-O-N-A-L, National Emblem, E-M-B-L-E-M, Emblem. So these are the two pictures given on our bank notes. The two pictures we have on our bank notes are of Mahatma Gandhi and our National Emblem. So giving you few seconds to write this, and after that we will be doing short question answers. Okay, so now everyone make heading of short question answer. So here we are starting with the short question answer. And the first question is, how do you pay when you travel in auto rickshaw or a bus? So do you all know about it? How do you pay when you travel in auto rickshaw? Hum auto rickshaw mein kaise pay karte hain? When we are going to travel in auto rickshaw or bus, to hum wahan kaise pay karte hain? Right? So let's learn about it and write the answer. We pay money in cash. Hum kya karte hain? Cash money pay karte hain while traveling in a bus or an auto rickshaw. So hum unko cash mein payment karte hain. It may be, it can be hum earn coins or it can be paper money. Right? So how do you pay when you travel in auto rickshaw or a bus? Write the answer. We pay money in cash, C-A-S-H, cash, while traveling in a bus or an auto rickshaw. So we pay money in cash while traveling in a bus or an auto rickshaw. So this was our first question of short one, and then second question we are starting. Second question is, where does the code number figure or on our bank notes? So कहाँ पर कॉर्ड नंबर जो फिगर किया हुआ है हमारे बैंक नोट्स में? Where does the कॉर्ड नंबर फिगर ऑन आर बैंक नोट्स? So yes, कॉर्ड नंबर इज प्रिंटेड. Write the answer. कहाँ कहाँ दिया होता है? I've shown you the picture of the note, and let I explain each and everything, that what are the pictures given, where it is the sign of governor of Reserve Bank of India, and where are the code numbers given on our bank notes. So yes, write the answer. Code number is printed in the top right hand corner and the bottom left hand corner of a note. Again, I'm repeating, where does the code number figure on our bank notes? Code number is printed in the top right hand corner, means this top right hand corner, this side, and the bottom left hand corner of a note. Okay, bottom of this side, left hand corner of a note. Giving you few seconds to write, then we will be starting with a long, and there is only one long question answer. Okay, so yes, everyone make a heading of long question answer now. Okay, so here is only one long question answer. Question number first. What is the difference What is the difference between, now we have to tell the difference. So what is the difference between a coin and a note? Between a coin and a note. Okay, so you know about the coin and the note. Coin is in the metal form and note is in the paper form. So we have to tell the difference between all both. So coin is made of metal. Write the answer. Coin is made of metal. Metal se banta hai coin, right? Whereas a note is made, whereas a note is made of paper. So jo note hai wo paper se banta hai. And the note means the money which made with the paper, that money is known as paper money. Okay, again repeating, coin is made of metal, whereas a note is made of paper. Now, notes are issued by IISSUED, notes are issued by the Reserve Bank of India. See, the first capital should be, first letter should be capital, and here also Reserve Bank of and India, and the Government of India, and the Government of India. If we are writing the name of any place, any country, so that should be in the capital, means first letter should be capital. So India here, and the government of India has the sole right, they have right to mint the coins. They have sole right to mint coins. Only they can issue us coins. So, who can issue us notes? Notes are issued by the Reserve Bank of India, and the government of India has the sole right to mint the coins. Only they can give us the coins. So, again repeating this question, and that is all for today. What is the difference between a coin and a note? Coin is made of metal, whereas a note is made of paper. Notes are issued by the Reserve Bank of India, and the Government of India has a sole right to mint the coins. So, yes, that is all for today. Everyone noted down in your previous notebooks properly. And the best for the exams. Now prepare for that. Thank you so much for watching, and bye-bye.